All right, guys, so it's been 10 long years since Mahindra came out with the first edition of the Thar, and I am so excited to be sharing this news with you all right now, because it's just a week before the iconic launch of the brand new, the completely changed, the completely revamped, the completely redesigned version of the Mahindra Thar on the 15th of August during Independence Day. And wait, hold on a second. I actually forgot my intro. Assalamu alaikum, namaste, namaskara. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Sharon Zakaria. Boom! So 10 years since the Mahindra Thar first launched on the roads of India, probably off the roads of India, because that's a better way to put it across. A lot of things have changed in the market, a lot of new competition, a lot of new foreign car makers, a lot of new sophisticated technology has come up in all the cars that's, you know, been made. So it was high time that Mahindra actually pulled up their socks and came up with something bigger, badder and better. And trust me, they have, because what they have done seems extremely promising. As you all know, a lot of, you know, pictures and videos of the test vehicles have been, you know, spotted across the country trying to do their research and development on different terrains. While all these things have been happening, Mahindra has finally, you know, announced their launch date to be the 15th of August. That's Independence Day, which is about a week from now. So just about a week before the launch of the vehicle, I think a few vehicles have actually reached Bangalore, and a few spy images have been posted online. I'm sure most of you must have already seen them by now. So I'm quickly going to show you all the pictures and my view of how the vehicle looks, you know, based on the pictures that's come up, because 95% of the vehicle has been shown, apart from the few coverings here and there, which Mahindra has of course tried to hide until the launch of the vehicle. And trust me, guys, the vehicle actually looks very, very promising. So let's quickly get into the pictures and not waste any more time and see what we think about the vehicle. All right, guys, so here we have the all new Mahindra Thar that has been spotted just a few hours before this video is shot. And man, oh man, it looks brilliant. Look at the color scheme, guys. You know, this is the same color scheme that, you know, that Mahindra came up with the Thar 700 series, the last 700 of the car Thars to be made of the previous version. And they have tried managing, you know, they've tried keeping it all hidden and, you know, secretive, so no one sees it until its launch. And at the first glance, what I can personally tell you all, what I can, you know, purely tell you all, is that this vehicle is a lot bigger, a lot wider and badder than the previous version of the Thar, guys. It looks really good. I really like how the car is shaped and how boxy the vehicle looks, because the Jeep is all about being boxy and, you know, and looking good. So first things first, the first change that I've noticed is that the front end of the glass does not have the, you know, the same old rubber beadings, if you can notice. So a lot of, you know, owners of the previous version of the Thar have complained of water leakage, of water seeping in through, you know, during rains and, you know, during while washing the cars and everything, while having the rubber beadings on. So Mahindra has gotten rid of them and has infused them with full stretched glass. So that is a very good move, which would probably lead to a lot less water seeping and, you know, water leakage into the vehicle. And next thing is that, you know, you can see that the typical old school lock for the bonnet has been replaced with these Wrangler style locks. That looks, you know, kind of sporty and, you know, much futuristic than, you know, how it looked previously, because the Mahindra Thar has been, you know, showcasing and sporting the same old hook kind of lock since a very long time over the years. And the next big change that you can see is that the Mahindra Thar now comes with a 5-spoke alloy wheels, and that looks really good. These look really big, guys, because this looks at least an easy 16 or 17 inch, and they look really good. And the tires also look different. The tires are not too clear to read, so the names are not too clear to read. So let's probably slide into the next frame. And before that, if you can notice, Mahindra has changed the rear view mirrors on the sides, and they've also given it a branding of the Thar in the at the outer box and outer column of the mirror. And these look much wider than the previous version of the Thar, because the previous version of Thar, the vision on the rear view mirror does not, you know, go with the body of the vehicle, because it absolutely sucks, guys. And a lot of people spend about 10,000, 10,500, 11,000 on these fake Wrangler type mirrors, which are sourced from third-party vendors, and they get them fixed on their Thars. And Mahindra has made a really good move by changing the mirrors, so it gives the wider body a much wider view at the rear end of the vehicle. And it also looks good with the Thar branding there. And next thing is that They've changed the footstep on the side of the vehicle, and this is not the same footstep that used to come in the previous version of the Thar CRDE. That was more of a metal footstep, and this is more of a flatter footstep, which makes it a little more sporty compared to the previous version of the Thar. And moving on, before I could move on, I want to show you that the vehicle is registered. There's a temporary certification of the vehicle, which is registered in KA01. It's a Koromal RTO in Bangalore. And this shows that one of the Bangalore showrooms has the vehicle right now, but it is probably at the company depot or somewhere that I do not have knowledge of. So moving on to the next slide, as you can see, the side profile view of the vehicle. And here we can see that the tires are really big, and it is no longer the Bridgestone Dulers that used to come in the previous version of the Thar. This is the C8. C's are all-terrain tires, and man, they look pretty big and wide. And I'm sure this is a 16 or 17 inch rim, because they look really good and go with the color of the vehicle really well. And you can see the color of the vehicle is very clearly shown, and as the cloth has been lifted on top, and this has been covered with a lot of Velcro, and you can see the Thar branding on the rear view mirrors here. And they've retained the same old wiper blades, which is not that great and tends to wear out really soon, and does not do a great job in taking the water off the mirror, taking the water off the glass. And of course, you can see the side step from this angle, which is a lot clearer, which is a lot flatter. And the wheel arches are almost identical to the previous version of the Thar at the rear end. And the front end of the wheel arch has indicators which are infused within the wheel arch, which looks similar from the previous version of the Thar, which has been borrowed from the previous versions. And the next major change that you can notice is that the fuel cap, the fuel tank, has been shifted from the right hand side to the left hand side of the vehicle. This is a big change, because the previous models of the Thar used to have their fuel tanks at the right hand side of the vehicle, and this has it on the left hand side of the vehicle, making it a lot more convenient for people to fuel up. And it is much, much higher than the previous version of the Thar, because the previous version of the Thar, it is very difficult for the lock of the pump to go and sit inside, because someone has to hold it until the tank gets filled. And the next big change that you can see in the Thar is that the company gives an option of a soft top as well as a hard top. And if you can see that this vehicle has a fiber hard top, what seems to be like a fiber hard top, with glass, properly sealed and done really well. It looks really neat on the vehicle. Moving to the next slide, we can see that the interiors look extremely good, guys. The interiors look extremely sporty, extremely luxurious. Compared to any of its previous models, if you can see, the roof of the vehicle is no longer that the cloth material, cardboard sheet, or whatever you want to call it, because that's how it feels like. And this seems to be like solid metal with these nice lines to add onto the design here. And they've changed the rear view mirror inside, which is a much needed change, as it is a lot wider and bigger than the rear view mirrors that used to come in the previous model of the Thar. And you have these the defoggers here, the vents here that come out on the glass. And you can also notice that the company has given a full-fledged infotainment system with a lot of options. I think this is a touchscreen infotainment system, which comes with the volume option here. I can barely see the call option here with all these buttons and a lot of other features that go along with it. And if you can see that there's a major change on the front instrument cluster on the dashboard. The previous model of the Thar used to come with about three circles, which has the speedometer, the tachometer, the speed gauge, so the heat gauge, the temperatures, and the fuel gauge and all of that. So that has been changed. I think this is a digitalized version of the same thing, but I'm not sure too sure about how it looks, because I don't have a clear view of it. The air vents, the AC vents, look pretty much similar, and it is borrowed from the previous version of the Thar. From what it seems like, it has a chromium finish to the edges of it. And you can notice that there is a three-spoke steering wheel, which it has a lot of button controls on the steering, which is a new in terms of the Mahindra Thar, which has a lot of features on the steering wheel, as you don't have to really touch the infotainment system here to access all the all the apps or maps or whatever you want to use in the infotainment system. And you have the Thar branding here, which looks really nice on the side door. And you have the locks that has been changed, the knob of the lock that has been changed, because the previous version had the knobs here, which looked very old school and which felt very old school as well, because those are actually made out of very, you know, bad quality plastic, and they tend to break off every time you try opening them and closing them. I have broken about 3 or 4 sets of mine already, and I've been driving around without any lock knobs there. And you have these compartments where you can keep things, and you have a cup holder there, which I can notice. And next big thing is that, you know, the gear knobs, the gear levers have been changed drastically. And if you can notice, the four-wheel gear lever has been shifted from the right-hand side to the left-hand side of the main gearbox. And this, I can, as far as I can see, I think is a 6-speed gearbox with a reverse gear. And the four-wheel drive gear knob has been moved to the left-hand side. Which is a very good change, because someone as tall as me, who's about 6 feet 2 inches, it finds it very difficult on the previous version of the Thar to drive when the gearbox, when the four-wheel gearbox is actually protruding out of the front column of the dashboard. And it tends to get a little irritating and a little hurtful when you're driving, when you're on a long drive and you're driving long distances. So that change is really good, and I feel it is, you know, it's going to make the drive quality a lot more better. And if you can see that there is a bottle cup holder here, and if you can see that the car comes with 2 power windows as standard, you can see the power windows switches here. They're standard in the new Mahindra Thar, which obviously means that you don't have to spend about 10,000 rupees on getting an aftermarket power window fitted. And you don't have to keep, you know, rotating the knob as and how you feel like, you know, endlessly. And here you have a space compartment. I think this is to store your mobile phones and to charge your mobile phones. And you can see an output where, you know, where the wires are being connected. I think that is where the USB output is at. And you can see that, you know, the AC controls have been changed from the previous version, because the previous version has just 2 knobs where you just have to turn for the temperature and to, you know, to turn the AC on and off. But here you have a lot of controls and buttons on how you want the AC and the air to be circulated inside. And you have a lot of buttons and switches here, which has the hazard lamp and, you know, a lot of loads of other features here. And that's about it for the front end of the interiors. And here you have the rear end of the vehicle, which looks very boxy and nice. And you have a nice wide glass, a nice good view at the background. You can see that the rear view mirrors can act really well. At the, you know, because of those wide angle glass that we have here, and the tires are really big, guys. I'm sure it is at least a 16 inch or 17 inch, like I said previously. And you can see that the parking lights and the brake lights have been completely changed. You can see that there's a Thar branding here, and these are much bigger than the previous lights and much wider in terms of the way it looks. And this looks really good, because you have the Live Young, Live Free tagline of Mahindra, which comes in practically all vehicles, all SUVs of theirs. And you have the new redesigned bumpers at the rear end, which has the metal cladding, the aluminium plating in the center of it, in the center portion of it, which looks really good. And this looks very sporty and makes the vehicle look really good. The stance of the vehicle completely has changed compared to the previous version, because the previous version has this hard plastic and, you know, this hard metal bumper at the rear end, which looks really good for that particular model. But this really suits the way it looks, guys. And considering how the door opens, I'm not quite sure of how it would open, because you can see these 2 hinges here. I think the glass goes upwards, whereas the door comes separately. I'm not too sure. Let's quickly move into the next slide. So here we have the rear end of the vehicle, the rear side of the interiors. So this is the hardtop version. This is where we have the fiber hardtop. And if you can notice immediately, the side facing seats do not exist anymore. I think this is on the hardtop version of the vehicle. I'm not too sure if the soft top comes with the side facing seat option, because that is the actual purpose of a real Jeep, and that's how I prefer my Jeep being. So talking about this particular model, you have the front facing seats, which can accommodate up to 3 people, probably 2 adults and one child in between. On the whole, you can determine that the Thar is a 5-seater car, which does its role really well. I think a person with an average height of about 5.8 to 5.10, or probably even a 6 feet tall person can, you know, comfortably sit at the back. But the whole question is, how are they going to enter inside? I think the front side seat, the co-passenger seat in the front, is probably going to be slided up front, and then the passengers would have to enter from the front end. I don't know how it's going to work. We could hopefully see it only when the vehicle comes out and once we get to it in person. And you can also see that, you know, there are speakers given by the factory itself, and you have these grab handles here so you just don't lose balance, and you know, because of all the rocking and movement of the vehicle, because the Jeep and the Thar especially is known to be extremely bumpy on how you drive it on bad roads. So the speaker slots have gone up to the roof, you know, from being at the bottom, because in the previous versions of the Thar, you would have had to buy yourself a third party speaker, and you would have had to, you know, put it in the slots, which is right behind the driver's seat here. So that has been shifted from the bottom to the roof. That is a good move, because if in case you are ever, you know, water wading, or since the seats have been changed to the front facing end, I think that does a lot more justice in way the speakers have been placed, because that would give out a good effect. And you can also see that there are rollover protection bars, so that if in case, since this is a fiber hardtop along with the B pillar and the C pillar, which is mandatory in the new model of the hardtop variant of the vehicle, based on the BS6 compliant that they've tried to register it as, it would actually help the vehicle in sustaining a considerable amount of damage that could be done during a collision or during an accident. So keeping all this in mind, I think, you know, the interiors and the whole overall quality of the build quality of the vehicle and overall look of the vehicle, overall stance of the vehicle looks amazing. So this is how the vehicle looks for one last time. I think the interiors looks fabulous, man. I wish I had this interior on my Thar. But nevertheless, I love my Thar the way it is, and trust me, that is going to be any day better than how it is right now, how the new one's going to be. So all things said and done, guys, I really hope you all liked watching this video. I hope you all found this video informative. I'm really excited to see this new vehicle in person at the showroom on the road. I can't wait to drive it myself. I'm definitely going to do a first look video, a first drive video or anything as such. So all things said and done, I hope you all like this video, and if you are watching this video for the first time, do subscribe to my channel for all my regular updates and all my regular videos that I'm going to be putting up, and do support me, guys. It means a lot when you all do. So thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you all in another video soon. Stay armored, stay protected, stay safe, and stay at home, guys.